A stone's throw from the shopping mecca of Cardiff city centre lies a street with a long history of homegrown business.
Good morning, Corey & Co. How can I help?
A kilometre-long melting pot of independent retailers, City Road is the country's most diverse street. Almost 60% of those who live here were born outside of Wales.
So much diversity in City Road. My Scottish accent is just adding to it, I think.
A place where new...
I hope open next month.
...and old collide.
I wouldn't like a business down yet, no it's altered.
Where change is inevitable, and fun times are always just around the corner.
Vibrating mascara looks kind of spiky.
Look at that!
On a street that was once the site for public executions...
I'm going to cry, you know.
..it's not always easy to survive. But the people of City Road have learned to come out fighting.
Let's go, Phil! Let's go!
And they never stay down for long.
I love you, Dave!
This is life on City Road.
It's a place to be for action.
Today, City Road is many things to many people.
City Road está muy bon, muy bon.
These days, the street is better known for its restaurants than its retail. And the businesses that thrive here are those that throw everything at it.
We've tried to go for a higher standard of what City Road's kind of been used to. Give me three.
Rolling with the punches.
For sure! Hey, harder! Hey.
And keeping up with the times.
Bum shaping.
Yeah.
One man who thinks opportunity knocks on City Road is Amjid.
It's looking good so far. Exciting times now, you know.
At the far end of the street, Amjid is transforming an old electronics shop into what will be the 58th restaurant on City Road.
It's looking fantastic. Exciting stuff.
Amjid has moved lock, stock and barrel from Glasgow, especially to open his business on this street.
Hey, bud. My wife, she's originally from Cardiff, and I used to go to City Road. I just kind of looked around and I thought, it just had a right good vibe, and I thought, I want to be part of this. Building materials, is it? So much diversity in City Road. That's one of the things I love about it. Me coming along with my Scottish accent is just adding to it, I think.
Right, I'll go in here and look good now.
Aye, cool, right. No problem with you, Faye.
Dundee, you
Dundee,
yourself?
I'm from Glasgow.
That sounds like good as well, eh?
Amjid's restaurant will be part of a national franchise.
Kebab is originally based around grilled Pakistani and Indian food, barbecue food.
And he thinks that attention to detail will be his recipe for success.
There's a bit of the arrow at the bottom there, the kind of skewer thing that's kind of sticking out a wee bit too much for my liking. Everything's got to be perfect from the word go, you know, and I'm hoping that when the people do come through the door, they'll see that the amount of effort that we have put into getting everything as perfect as we can, you know. Just try to go for a higher standard of what City Road's kind of been used to. We're just taking up a level, you know. And the thing is, sometimes when you do that, then it forces other businesses as well to kind of up their game as well.
Get in there, yeah.
Amjid's not the only one with an eye for detail.
I don't know about this colour.
His wife, Uzma, is also a bit of a perfectionist.
Are you sure that's the colour we chose?
Yeah. Uzma, my wife, she's got very high standards, but in a good way.
That's different, that's different, that's different.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, is it?
Shades of grey.
You want to just be right, you want to cut corners, make sure everything's right and stuff, you know?
Uzma's already spotted a problem with the sign outside.
The finishing is not very good.
No. The screws don't look as if they're very secure. And it's a very heavy sign, and it's the last thing you want it is falling on somebody's head.
But is there an even bigger problem with those chilies?
It's that bit at the bottom, not meant to be at the top. The chilies, are they the wrong way around?
Oh, my God. I think they have.
Quick, check the franchise website.
No, we're all right. Sorry, it's just me.
Once you go past this point, it's a little bit more eye-watering.
Just down the road from Amjid's restaurant...
The vibrated part is quite big.
Faith is taking an unusual goods delivery for her new passion project.
If you did pop in, I can show you it working.
She's turning the upstairs of her sexy shop into a combat sports gym.
Can I help with something?
More boxes. I'm emptying the boxing kit.
Okay, big boxes?
Yeah, bigger the better.
Okay, we have plenty of boxes.
It's all part of Faith's plan to diversify her business and keep the passion alive.
The building is so huge. First, we didn't use most of the space in here, but now rates have gone up so high and all the bills are going up and up and up, so using this space is going to be a wise move, I think.
There's another reason why Faith wants to transform her old storeroom.
Why have we got Vaseline?
That's a sparring. Eyebrows.
Oh, OK.
Top cuts.
And that is to keep fitness fanatic Paul happy.
Got a long history in combat sports with boxing, kickboxing. Took about 4 or 5 decent titles, all the big ones nationally.
He actually used to be my boxing coach, and that's how we knew each other.
A few years ago, when Faith's relationship broke up, Paul went from fitness coach to life coach.
I was kind of stranded when I split up from my partner. He was here 1 minute, and then the next day he's gone. Now I've got leaks all over the building and carrying big, massive, flipping heavy things up the stairs and this, that and the other, and I had to cope with it all on my own. And then Paul came to my rescue. I was like, Paul! And it was the time when you looked in the sewer one leg got covered in shit. He's my man Friday. That's why I want this room to be done, so that he sort of stays around.
All those years of college, all those years of reading, training, this, that and the other. I'm putting false cocks in a box. Aspirations, eh?
Let's have a look.
Downstairs in the shop, the training is just beginning for Faith's new employee.
That's not a dress, is it? No, it's not. Is that a dress?
It changes into a dress when you put it on.
Wow.
Siobhan will be the evening manager at Passion.
Well, I'm not very good at this, am I? Oh, no, I'm not very good at this at all.
I need to tighten things up financially and get even more sales if I can by opening till 9 p.m.
I don't know why I'm trying to give the mannequin some sort of modesty. There we are. Lovely.
Of course, it's vital Siobhan knows her way around the goods. From the smallest...
We've got handmade bikinis. They're mainly for strippers.
..to the biggest.
That's a bad boy, isn't it? It's fabulous. I want one.
And then we've got bum shaper pants.
Bum shaping?
Yeah, your bum comes through there and it makes it into a big, massive... into a big, massive round. I'm really quite interested to see how she's going to work out. Yeah, I think she'll be good.
Hiya, is it Jasmine?
At Kebabish Original, Amjid and Uzma have also been interviewing staff in anticipation of opening their restaurant in a couple of weeks.
Do you eat out much?
Not much, no. The only places I go really is like Nando's, and that's the only place I will go.
Yeah.
On site, building work continues. Amjid's brother has come all the way from Glasgow to check out progress, and he's impressed.
It looks pretty classy, doesn't it?
It is very. I like that. I'm really pleased for him. Proud that it's my brother that's doing this, you know? So...
Amjid's putting a brave face on it, but privately, the pressure is mounting.
I've not been really sleeping that well. I've been stressed out. I can't sleep.
For the last few weeks, progress on site has been painfully slow.
There's been a few delays, a few mix-ups.
You know, it's frustrating. There's a lot of interest in us opening. People want to book engagements. And we're having to knock all this custom back because of delays and the build.
And the delays just keep on coming.
Whoever put it on should have allowed a 5 mil gap, because it expands and shrinks So when it's all tight like that, if it expands, then it'll all sort of pop off. Can be annoying when something's done and then you've got to take it down and redo it, you know, so.
Inside, Amjid spared no expense on the fit-out.
I know I'm way over budget.
That's one of my flaws, I think it is, not looking at what things are going to be costing.
I should have had money coming in. I've had no money coming in for the last 6 months. It's a big pressure.
It's not just his own future that Amjid's worried about. He's also a father of four.
Every man and woman out there, when they've got kids, all they want to do is give them a better life. I put everything into this, and then, but it's always at the back of your mind. You know, what am I going to do? You know, how am I going to provide?
His solution is drastic.
I'm having to put my house up for sale, actually, to be honest with you, which is not very pleasing. For me or my wife, kids as well, you know, we're all upset about it, that we're having to sell up now. It's a sacrifice we're going to have to make for the business. Hopefully it'll pay off, you know, and the kids will understand why you had to do it, you know.
It's been one of the wettest winters in City Road's history.
It's like a fridge in here, isn't it?
And at Passion, it's having an inevitable effect on business.
It's cold because the shop is so big. But if we put all the heaters on, the electric blows up.
Upstairs.
Oh, this has got to go. Everything.
The weather is raining on Paul's parade too.
This room weren't even leaking before, was it?
And the state of the roof is putting a dampener on his plans to convert the old stock room into a gym.
The roof, there's a lot of a mess. It's soaking through and through. It needs replacing, but I think it's a 50 to 60 grand job. If they do put a new roof on it, we'll end up paying for it in the long run anyway, because it'll just go on top of the rent.
Faith, meanwhile.
So is he always the optimist?
Is still keeping the faith.
In right, left.
She knows it's not what you've got. It's what you do with it that matters.
You and me.
Always on the lookout for ways to monetize the spare space in the building, Faith has already converted the top floor into a burlesque and pole dancing studio. It's been a roaring success.
Up the belly.
In more ways than one.
It's a great way of increasing footfall through the shop. Obviously, with the dance lessons, if you need to dress up, then my place is the place to come for that type of product that you need.
So the corsets and things are over there. There's sparkly stuff all over the place.
My favourite.
Sparkly shoes, little burlesque hats, feather boas. So, yeah, double whammy, it's good all round.
One, two, three, four.
Going left, right, left, right, excellent. Left.
Downstairs, meanwhile, the last customer of the day is buying for a very special occasion.
Una piñata muito grande. Vamos a tener una brincadeira muy buena. A piñata leva todos os artículos que você quer agregar.
A piñata is a paper figure, usually filled with sweets and toys, that's broken open at a kid's party. Has our Portuguese-speaking tourist come to the wrong place?
Everything inside the piñata, is it sexy? Everything's sexy?
Yes, this is party for sex.
Apparently not.
Adult piñata party, I mean, the mind boggles. Bashing this thing and what's going to come out of it.
Pensando que o futuro, as mulheres não precisam de homem. Já tem tudo satisfação aqui. Sechon. City Row está muito bom, muito bom.
The world takes all sorts of people, you know, to make it interesting.
Bye bye, baby.
Bye bye.
Perhaps it's the location that attracts the colourful customers. City Road is the most eclectic mix of cultures and tastes. Visitors here can sample the flavours of 18 different countries. And behind every shop window, there's a great story waiting to be told.
Me, got one more!
Single shot here. Me. Oh, good shot.
Tucked away on one of City Road's side streets is the Ultimate Fitness Centre.
Again, for sure! Me.
Where champions are made.
Back on the shot here.
Denzel Lawrence, the owner, is a former world title kickboxer.
I was world champion, I was British champion, I became European champion, then I was world champion. I've done it and I'm proud of what I've done.
Now retired from fighting, Denzel trains current champions, including his own son, Levi, in his specially designed combat fitness gym.
The gym we got now is absolutely awesome.
Faster! Come on, keep it going!
You know, I fitted this on a gym that I would like to have gone to when, you know, I used to fight.
Come on!
In my gym, you got all walks of life. And they all mix, you all get on.
Let's go, changer!
Come on. It's the gym of the future.
Good, come on, get it up! That's it!
Tonight, Denzel is throwing open the gym doors to a bunch of boxing virgins.
We got a lot of new faces today, which is awesome. I think at the moment we got about 100 people.
These men and a few women are signing up to get fighting fit for a white-collar boxing event that Denzel is organising.
Who thinks white-collar boxing is easy?
White-collar boxing is something anyone can do. Teachers, doctors, civil servants, anyone who haven't thrown one punch in their life.
And they want to give up their free time, you know, to raise money for a charity.
So you're all going to train together for 9 weeks, and then you're going to step into the ring and fight each other, basically, for charity, for Help for Heroes. Yeah, so you obviously will...
A lot of people do not know what is involved, but it is an awesome journey and a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
Have you seen the Heroes 6 Minutes kit?
If anyone can get this bunch punching above their weight, it's Denzel.
Denzel's held multiple titles and trained multiple champions, including his son, Levi.
Tonight, it's standing room only. But next week, when the fists start flying...
Guys, Hero for 6 Minutes, yeah!
Who will still be standing?
Hi, Fiona, it's Amjad. Can you please give me a call back?
It's 6 months since Amjad began work on his dream restaurant on City Road. By his original schedule, he should have opened weeks ago. But without furniture or even a kitchen fitted, Amjad's nowhere near ready.
All this now, it's been like this for weeks. Everything just come to a total standstill. It doesn't matter who I phone, how many calls I make, none's happening. I had a delivery yesterday, but I'm waiting on kitchen equipment arriving.
Right, yeah.
Is there any deliveries due today? The plumbers, won't, and the gas guys won't come out until that stuff's on site.
I'm so sorry, I quite understand. Just bear with me a second, and I'm going to get you through.
For Amjad, it's not just the timescale that's the problem.
There's no money coming in. All the money's went out. We just got a gas bill for £796, but we've not used any gas whatsoever. Believe that.
Amjad and his wife, Uzma, have thrown everything they have into making the restaurant work.
My dreams and my wife's dreams, they've all pinned on this restaurant now. We've put everything we've had into this one project. It's a big gamble. And if it doesn't pay off, I don't know if you'll say you're going to be out in the streets, but you're going to be, everything's going to be, you're going to lose everything that we've worked for over the years.
By the time Roy the engineer turns up, Amjad is at rock bottom.
When I normally work, I play music. Otherwise, nothing much get done.
I'm nearly in tears just now, you know? No, I'm going to cry, you know, so I have to get off the phone, mate, OK? Singing, don't worry about a thing.
Cos on, man. You can't be looking stressed like this. Huh? But you can't change it, can you?
No.
If you could change it then, okay, but when it is what it is, you know what I mean?
I know.
That's
I know.
How it goes. But he's not looking too good, is he? Come on up. Sit up, man.
Yeah, I'm up. Huh? I'm up, bro.
You would think his role is over. And it's not even beginning yet. It started yet.
Yeah, I know, you're right. See, this guy worries me.
Come on, man.
Yeah, I got
to go back up there. Speak to you later.
All right, see you in a minute. All right. These guys just make me feel at home. They just make me feel as if I'm one of them and they're looking after me. And it means so much to me. And turning me into a Cardiff boy, you know. I'd fly the Welsh flag as much as I would fly the flipping Scottish flag. Put it that way, you know. That's how much these guys have been doing for me, you know.
A few weeks later, the residents of City Road get a reminder of just how quickly the best laid business plans can go up in flames.
Oh, God. Just gotta be so careful. You'll be out of business. It's devastating.
I'm just hoping that this ambulance isn't for one of the firefighters.
This year, the street and its residents have seen their fair share of drama.
This is the third fire in City Road in, like, a month.
Scary.
But city roaders are made of strong stuff. And sometimes after the darkest of nights come the brightest of dawns.
Last night there was a major fire on City Road, just across the road from me. This morning I was hoping to come down because we were expecting a big delivery coming. For the rest of the stuff from the catering company, you know. But all the roads have been blocked off. There was a lot of police kind of activity going on. It's all happening in City Road. It's the place to be for the action, without a doubt. And, you know, it's kind of brought... I know I shouldn't say it, but it's kind of brought a small smile to my face, you know, a bit of action. With everything that's been going on with me, but obviously circumstances, you know, I can't do nothing about that. Hey, come on, son, let's go. You're going as well, you think, you know what, yeah, we've come too far now to look back. We're going to smash it. We're absolutely going to smash it.
It's Valentine's Day. And at Passion, everyone and everything is feeling the love.
Here we are.
It's Valentine's Day every day in here, so we thought we'd have a little bit of an event just to celebrate that.
Even on the most romantic day of the year, Faith has to work hard to pull in the punters.
Let's make this place look beautiful.
City Road is such a diverse road, but it's not anywhere where I'd get footfall. There's, you know, no passing trade for my business, so we're promoting ourselves and, you know, being out there a bit more.
Oh, no! Oh. They're all tangling! Help!
Inside, too, Faith wants to woo her customers.
Hello!
How's it going?
And has asked the girls from her burlesque fitness class to provide the entertainment. It all seems to be bringing out people's romantic sides.
There you go, my lovely. All right.
As well as their wallets.
Thank you very much.
I'm getting good at this, aren't I?
With new assistant Siobhan holding the fort, Faith's grand plan to increase the bottom line and diversify is coming together.
Having Siobhan there is definitely going to actually free me up a little, and then I can concentrate on running every part of the business.
It's a business that's now making an impact.
Don't load it up, just pop it out. Put a left hook on the end.
Upstairs, Paul's plans to turn Faith's warehouse into a war house have finally come together.
The room's ready, more or less. Now I've got to fill it, I've got to pay for it. Get all the gear, I've got Andy's new hams to put inside them. So, put a four-shot combo. One, two, left hook, straight right.
It's just such a relief to have it up and running. It was a great use of the room. We've been before, it wasn't really making any money. So I think Paul's happy now as well. So I think he'll be with us for a while. I can't get rid of him now.
You really think your man Friday would have left you stranded, Faith?
No, I wouldn't have left. Family and friends first. Probably cost me over the years, but I can sleep at night, so... Straight right!
Aw.
I love watching him doing this. I want to have a go.
You go, girl.
Can't touch this.
While Faith and Paul are just starting to punch their way into profit, down the road at Ultimate Fitness.
Okay, the old empty hammer shit. Okay, let's go.
The gloves are off.
Hey! No!
Last week, 120 people signed up to be a hero for 6 minutes in Denzel's amateur boxing charity challenge.
Break it down.
Come on, let's dig in. Let's go. Come on.
It's 3 2-minute rounds, so you fight for 6 minutes.
Change stance and keep punching.
It's going to be the hardest 6 minutes of your life.
Come on, single punch, come on.
Two people who are determined to go the distance are Mo.
Get bigger than me, come on, push me back.
And Charlie.
Okay, guys, okay.
One thing I do like about Charlie, I think she's quite aggressive. She's quite spunky.
My husband thinks it's a stupid idea, but hey.
What I've seen of Mo, you know, I think he lacks a lot of fitness, but he hasn't done nothing whatsoever before. So, you know, fair dues, I take my hat off to anyone who wants to do this.
Mo and Charlie have their own reasons for wanting to take part.
I'm a little bit of an adrenaline junkie. I always need something in life to challenge me, to be honest.
Come on!
Fitness-wise, get a bit of fitness. I wanted to lose some weight as well. 2016, new me.
The minds are willing.
Jabbo, come on, let's go.
But with just 9 weeks to go before they have to fight, will these bodies be able?
Of course I'll make it to the end. I don't know whether I'll win or lose, it doesn't matter. It's just a new challenge, just getting to the end is what counts.
Obviously there's boys in here who's been boxing 4 or 5 years. So that's why, like, if I train hard enough, maybe I'll get them to fight, so we'll see.
While for some, the hard work is just beginning.
First training session out the way. Well done.
For others on City Road, there's plenty of time for fun.
I can't wait to go to bed.
And a chance to make a brighter future in which everyone has their moment to be a hero.